But that's okay, I understand. They let him out on the weekends anyway, and he does these concerts. There's a guy named Bobby Emmons that's from New Jersey, and he sings doo-wop music. That's what he calls it. We don't hear that out in California. He says back here they stand around the street corners and sing, just like in that movie Rocky. Is that right? They stand around the corner to set garbage cans on fire and then sing, right? That sounds good. Well, little Bobby Emmons and his group, the Crosstones, they sing rock and roll music about Jesus, but it sounds like it's from the 50s. Well, you know, it's that kind of music. And you can't, I don't think it's in some stores, but there's about four copies back there, and some guy was saying, hey, you ought to hear this group, man. They're great. They sing about Jesus, and they sing 1950s music. And they do. If you like 1950s music, but don't buy all the records, okay? There's only four of them. Bud likes to turn everything into ashtrays, candy dishes. He just pours lighter fluid in the middle, and at least that's what he did with my records I gave him. We don't really try to frustrate the few of you that were asking. We didn't really finish our albums in 1977 and then just hold off. You know, have you noticed that there's an increasing interest in Christian music that maybe is not healthy? A lot of you, or I'll say us, a lot of us, buy records at the Bible bookstore and then we don't even listen to them all the way through. Because about the time we're halfway into the first side, they release another five albums. You know, you have to go down and check out which one of those you should get. Well, maybe you shouldn't get any of them. Maybe you shouldn't buy my album or Randy's or Daniel Amos's. Maybe you should, you know, buy some Bibles for your friends. Or I tell you what you ought to do. You ought to buy one album this year. You ought to buy Bob Dylan's album. You know, if you're going to... You really should. It's called Slow Train Coming. And if you have enough money to buy a second album, that probably means you don't drive a car. But I think you ought to listen to Bob Dylan's album. It's a beautiful statement right from his heart. If God is my father, then you are my brother. Why can't we bother to really reach out and love one another? Why do we keep on acting the way we do? The way we treat each other, it must break his heart in two. Why do we argue? Why are there so many churches? With half of them empty, and some represent $1 million purchase. What's happened to the message given by our Lord to take his gospel to the streets and share our money with the poor and learn to love? Love is the greatest. We gotta learn to love, because love is the greatest thing. And the Bible says you gotta learn to love your neighbor as yourself. Love your neighbor as yourself. But you can't love your neighbor if you don't love yourself. Some of you don't love yourselves. You don't like yourselves. You don't like the way you look. You look into the mirror and you think you're too tall, or you're too short, or you're too fat, or you're too skinny, or you don't like your hair being so curly, or you don't like it straight, or you wish it was dark, or you wish it was light, or you wish you could get a tan, or you wish you didn't get freckles or pimples. And we look at other people and we don't like the way they look. We don't like the way they talk. We don't like the way they act. Sometimes we think they're obnoxious. You know, they're always coming up to us, talking too much and always hanging around, and we wish they'd just go away and just quiet down, go home, and problem is, and you know, it's just probably they're insecure. They want some attention, not because they need it, because they just wanna. They wanna say, hey, hey, I'm nice guy. Really, I am. I mean, how come you don't like me? You know, how come nobody likes me? I have a right to live on the planet too. You know, I'm a person. Everybody always acts like I'm not. So instead of pushing people away, reach out and pull them closer. Let them know that you love them, because God loves them and He loves you. And learn to love. Love covers a multitude of sins. Love does not keep a list of wrong. Love has hope. Why don't we listen to God? Why don't we read the Bible? How come we read so many other books about the Bible? Paperback books that they write. 17 different books on the shelf, all about the same subject matter, and not all of the books agree. And how do you know which one is right? You're gonna read all 17 and figure it out for yourself, or you could just read one. I know one book. You could read the Bible. You could listen to God, and you could pray, and you could think. I mean, isn't it possible? There's a lot of things we're being taught that aren't the truth. I mean, maybe they're the truth, but maybe they're not the truth. I mean, is it true? Is it really true? You could tell God what you want. You can claim something, and God has to give it to you because you told Him you had to. Maybe it's true. Maybe God has to. I mean, if you claim something. Well, no, have you thought about it? Well, just think about it. Who's your shepherd? Who's your elder? Who are you under submission to? Who is your covering? God is your covering. God is who you're to be under submission to. You don't have to ask your brother what God wants you to do. Ask God what He wants you to do. And maybe you can ask your brother if he thinks that's a good idea, and would he help you if he could? Whatever happened to the idea that comes from the Bible about dying to self and living daily under God? Dying daily to self and living unto God. Instead of wanting everything to be perfect and trying to claim every kind of trouble, just claim it away. And you want everything in life to be perfect, and you want all kinds of nice things, and you claim a new car, and you like that girl, you claim that girl too, and you need a little more money, so you claim it, or you go down to Atlantic City and hope they don't check your ID too close. And then you got to learn to love. Instead of claiming everything, learn to die. Learn to love. Love is the greatest thing. We got to concentrate on Jesus. Concentrate on Jesus. Turn away from your sin and get ready for your new life. You know He said He's coming back again, and if you want to go with Him, you gotta let Him in. You gotta learn to love. Love is the greatest thing. Whoa. Some say He was an outlaw, that He roamed across the land with a band of unschooled ruffians and a few young fishermen. No one knew just where He came from or exactly what He'd done, but they said it might be something bad that keeps Him on the run. Some say He was a poet, that He'd stand upon the hill and His words could calm an angry crowd or make the waves stand still. And He spoke in many parables that few could understand, but the people sat for hours just to listen to this man. Some say He was a sorcerer, a man of mystery. He could walk upon the water, could make a blind man see, and He conjured wine at weddings and did tricks with fish and bread. He talked of being born again. He raised people from the dead. Some say a politician, he talked of being free. He was followed by the masses on the shores of Galilee. He spoke out against corruption, and He bowed to no decree. And they feared his strength and power, so they nailed him to a tree. Some say he was the Son of God, a man above all men, but he came to be a servant and to set us free from sin. And that's who I believe he was, 'cause that's who I believe. And I think we should get ready, 'cause it's almost time to leave. And I think we should get ready, 'cause it's time for us to leave. Life was filled with guns and war, and everyone got trampled on the floor. Wish we'd all been ready. Children died, the days grew cold. A piece of bread could buy a bag of gold. I wish we'd all been ready. There's no time to change your mind. The sun has come and you've been left behind. Asleep in bed, she hears a noise and turns her head. He's gone. I wish we'd all been ready. Two men walking up a hill, one disappears and one's left standing still. I wish we'd all been ready. There's no time to change your mind. How could you have been so blind? The Father spoke, the demons died. The Son has come, and you've been left behind. You've been left behind. You've been left behind.
See you in 15 minutes.